Hello Hunters, today I bring you my Frostcraft Longsword build as promised. This build works for both ES slash into Spirit Helmbreaker combo and Secret Sheath into Spirit Release slash combo. If you haven't reached Volcana or Risen Warstrax yet, you can also check out my previous Longsword build in the description below. Now without further ado, let's get started. For the weapon, we are using Volcana's weapon for ice damage. You can also use any other elemental longsword as well as raw longsword. On this, I slot in a Handicraft Jewel level 4 and an Anti-Monster Jewel in the Rampage slot. Risen Kaiser Horns from Risen Teostra with Critical Jewel and a Tenderizer Jewel. Rimguard Mail from Volcana with Hard Frost Jewel level 4, a Tenderizer Jewel and a Frost Jewel. Rimguard Gloves from Volcana with Handicraft Jewel, a Critical Jewel and Iron Shell Jewel. Rimguard Coil from Volcana with 3 Expert Jewels. Warstrax Graves from Risen Warstrax with Mastery Jewel level 4 and 2 and an Iron Shell Jewel. My Talisman has 3 level attack boost, a level 2 slot and level 1 slot. On this, I slot in Attack Jewel and Intrepid Jewel. For the augmentations, on the weapon, I win 4 on attack and 1 elemental boost. On the helmet, I have Bloodlust. On the chest, I have Flinch Free and Status Trigger, which is not required. On the gloves, I have attack boost. On the waist, I have Wind Mantle. And finally, on the legs, I have a few slot upgrade, which is also not required. Now your final skills should look like this. Attack boost level 7, critical eye level 5, ice attack level 5, now you can swap out to any other elemental attack. Critical boost level 3, weakness exploit level 3, master's touch level 3, handicraft level 3, quick sheath level 3, stun resistance level 3, frostcraft level 3 is our main skill, focus level 2, critical jewel level 2, Kushala blessing level 2, now if you're using fire, you can also swap out to Teostra's blessing level 2. Flinch Free level 1 is for multiplayer, Bloodlust level 1. When we are inflicted by Bloodlust, we'll gain attack boost. As soon as the disease is cured, we'll gain affinity boost by 20%. Intrepid Heart level 1 is a comfy skill, it will allow us to take a free hit from time to time. Wind Mantle is from augmentations, it's good to have but it's not required. And finally Powder Mantle from Resin Teostra, it will give us some free damage. There's no mandatory food skills, but I recommend Dango Booster, Dango Weakener and Dango Moxie. For the switch skills, I use two different playstyle on red scroll and blue scroll. On the red, I have draw double slash, spirit run slash combo, special sheath combo, soaring kick, harvest moon. On the blue scroll, I have draw double slash, spirit run slash combo, secret sheath combo, silkbound sakura slash, and serene pose. Now there you have it, my Frostcraft longsword build. This build is very versatile, it can be used as elemental build as well as raw damage build, and it works for many different playstyle. So now Frostcraft is almost mandatory skill for longsword. I hope you enjoyed the video, thanks for watching and see you next time.